Hello dear students, welcome in this maths class. Let's solve this question. The question is, a fraction becomes 9 over 11 if 2 is added both the numerator and denominator. If 3 is added to both numerator and denominator, it becomes 5 over 6. Find the fraction. So we have one fraction. Suppose numerator is x and denominator is y, then fraction becomes x over y. So first condition is, if 2 is added both the numerator and denominator, it becomes 9 over 11. It means if I add 2 in the numerator, it becomes x plus 2, and 2 in the denominator also, it becomes y plus 2. So the fraction will be x plus 2 over y plus 2. That is equal to 9 over 11 according to question. So this will be our first linear equation. Now for second, he is saying that 3 is added to both numerator and denominator, it becomes 5 over 6. Then let's add 3. So fraction becomes x plus 3 over y plus 3, then it will be equal to 5 over 6. So now the second linear equation is having. So we have a pair of linear equations in two variables now, and we can solve this by any of the method. So let's start. First of all, we'll write that let numerator be x and denominator be y. So fraction is x over y. So now first condition is, we'll write according to question. Our first condition is, if 2 is added both the numerator and denominator, it means x plus 2 and y plus 2. Now he's saying that it becomes 9 over 11. It becomes 9 over 11. So equal to 9 over 11. Now we can do cross multiply and we can find the first linear equation here. So cross multiply, we'll multiply with 11 these two. So it becomes 11 into x plus 2 is equal to 9 into y plus 2. So that implies 11x plus 11 2's are 22. Is equal to 9y plus 9 to the 18. So it becomes, we'll bring these variable terms to left hand side. So it becomes 11x minus 9y and constant terms to right hand side. So this is, so it becomes 11x minus 9y is equal to minus 4. So this is our first linear equation. Now again, we have, he's saying that if 3 is added to both the numerator and denominator, it becomes 5 over 6. So according to question, again, you can write according to question, if x plus 3 over y plus 3, means 3 is added to both numerator and denominator, it becomes 5 over 6. Now again, we need to do cross multiplication. So 6 into this and 5 into this. 6 into x plus 3 is equal to 5 into y plus 3. So here 6x plus 18 is equal to 5y plus 5 threes are 15. So it becomes, bring these variable terms to left hand side. So it becomes 6x minus 5y is equal to 15 minus 18. So it becomes 6x minus 5y is equal to minus 3. This is our second equation. Now we'll solve these two equations, linear equations, with substitution method. So what we do, from equation 1, we find out the value of x in terms of y. So we'll write from equation 1, we have here 11x is equal to minus 4 plus 9y. So I can write 9y plus minus 4. So x will be 9y minus 4 over 11. So this is suppose equation number 3. Now we'll fill equation number 3 in equation number 2 here. So we'll write, put equation 3 in equation 2. So let's see what will be happened. This is 6x, 6, and in place of x we'll write 9y minus 4 over 11 minus 5y is equal to minus 3. So that implies multiply with 6 these two terms. So 9 6 are 54y minus 6 4 are 24 over 11 minus 5y is equal to minus 3. So that implies we'll take 11 LCM here. So 11 1s are 11, so we'll multiply with 1, it becomes 54y minus 24. Here 1 is in the denominator, so 1 11s are, so multiply with 11, so 11 5s are 55. So let's see what will be there. 54 minus 55y, so it is minus y, minus 24 is equal to, we can cross multiply 11 here, so it becomes minus 33. So from here minus y is equal to, take this 24 to right hand side, it becomes minus 33 plus 24. So it becomes minus y is equal to minus 9. So minus minus will be cancelled. So the value of y is here 9. So value of y is 9. So now we'll fill the value of y as 9 in equation 3. So we'll write, put y is equal to 9 in equation 3. So it will be, see here, x is equal to 9 into y, that is 9 into 9 minus 4 over 11. So it is 9 9s are 81 minus 4 over 11. So 81 minus 4 is 77 over 11. So 11 1s are 11, 11 7s are. So it means x is 7. So required fraction is x over y, that is 7 over 9. So this is our required fraction. So this way we will do this question. Thanks for watching.